Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. Several days ago, we took apart the Charger King, the EGO EXINNO 240W, which can support up to 240W and charge 6 devices at the same time. You can click the upper right corner to check that. And today we got another 6 charging ports desktop charger from UGREEN, which can support up to 200W. So ChargerLAB also gonna test and take it apart. Let's go! The packaging looks very high-end, with golden product name on the black background. Open the box, the charger is protected by a plastic film and fixed in the middle. It also comes with a thick power cord and a charging cable. This is a woven cable, and the connector is printed with UGREEN. The length of the cable is about 1.04 meters. The power cord plug is matte with a small hole in the middle. And what we got is a UK standard plug. The other side is the 3-prong port, printed with 2.5 amp, 250 volts. There is a 13 amp fuse inside the input plug for overcurrent protection. This charger is pretty like a mini version of the Mac Mini, and the UGREEN logo is in the middle. 4 USB-C ports and 2 USB-A ports are on the side, and the USB-A port is purple. There's a rubber pad on each corner, and the specs info is in the middle. Model is CD271. It can support input of 100 to 140 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 2.5 amp. The USB-C 1C2 can support up to 100 watts, and the USB-C 3C4 supports up to 65 watts. The USB-A 1A2 only supports up to 22.5 watts. The size of this desktop charger is 100 by 100 by 32 mm, a square, and the weight is about 513 grams. The ChargerLAB Power ZKT002 shows the USB-C 1 supports almost all mainstream fast charging protocols, and the USB-C 1 also supports 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols and PDL information of USB-C 2 are the same as USB-C 1, so both ports have the same performance and can support up to 100 watts. The supported protocols of USB-C 3 are the same as USB-C 1, C2, but the PDL information of USB-C 3 is slightly different, only 20V, 3.25 amp, not 5 amp. The supported protocols of USB-C 4 are also the same as the other 3 USB-C ports, and the PDL information of USB-C 4 is also the same as USB-C 3. And then the USB-A1 port also supports all mainstream fast charging protocols except for PD and PPS. And the USB-A2 is the same as USB-A1. After the brief introduction of this desktop charger, let's take it apart and check why it can charge up to 6 devices at once. Firstly, use the spudger to remove the top case. There is a large heatsink for heat dissipation. Take out the PCBA module. The back of the module is also covered with a brass heatsink. Remove the heatsink. The PFC boost inductor and transformer on the front are filled with thermal adhesives for heat dissipation. Clean up the module. All plug-in components are soldered on the front. The input socket is at the bottom, and the input circuits are on two sides. Flip to the back, we can see some SMD components, including the MCU. ChargerLAB found it adopts the PFC circuit and LLC topology. There are 5 secondary buck circuits to regulate the fixed voltage and support fast charging of 6 USB ports. Next, let's introduce every single component inside. The input fuse is from Conker, 5A, 250 volts. The black NTC thermistor is from Shiheng Electronics. The diameter is 13 mm, and cold resistance is 1.50. The blue-white capacitors are used to suppress common mode interference, and the first common mode choke is behind it. Another white capacitor is on the other side of the input socket. The safety X2 capacitor is 0.33 microfarad. 2 bridge rectifiers are from Pingwei and connected in parallel. The heatsink between them can enhance heat dissipation performance. Then, the pulsed DC is filtered by 2 film capacitors and toroidal core filter inductor. The film capacitors are from Nissei, 1 microfarad, 450 volts. Next, here is the mass controller of this charger, which is from NXP. It integrates independent PFC controller and LLC controller and improves space utilization. 2 GaN ICs for PFC boost are from Innoscience, 650 volts, 260 milliohm. The PFC boost rectifier is from Pingwei and adopts a DFN 8x8 package, 650V, 6A. The PFC boost inductor is slightly wound with tape for insulation, and the thermistor is wrapped in heat shrink tube used for overheating protection. Two AiSHi filter capacitors are connected in parallel and used for PFC output filtering, 450V, 68μF. Two GaN ICs for LLC topology is also from Innoscience, same model as that of the PFC boost. The LLC resonant capacitor is 0.033μF, 630V. And here is the resonant inductor. The filter capacitor that powers the primary controller is from Capxon, 47μF, 35V. Three SMDY capacitors are all from TRX, filtering in small size and lightweight. The EL1019 optocoupler is used to regulate the output voltage. Two output solid capacitors are vertically soldered on a small PCB, 820μF, 25V. The synchronous rectifier controller is under the solid capacitors and from NXP. It integrates drivers for LLC synchronous rectification. Next, let's talk about these five independent box circuits. Four of them are the same, the other one is used for two USB-A ports. The protocol chip and MOSFET are soldered on the back of the small PCB. Three capacitors and an inductor are on the front of each PCB. Three capacitors are from Capxon, used for the buck and output filtering, 220μF, 25V. The protocol chips of five box circuits are from iSmartware, SW3516H, which is used for buck control and protocol identification. Two synchronous buck MOSFETs can form the half bridge and are from Elopac, 40V, 6.8mΩ. Here is the small PCB for two USB-A sockets. The output and input filter capacitors are wrapped with heat shrinkable tube and heat-resistant tape, respectively. The input filter capacitor is 220μF, 25V. The output filter capacitor is 330μF, 16V. Both are from Capxon. The protocol chip and synchronous buck MOSFETs of two USB-A ports are the same as the USB-C ports. Two V-bus MOSFETs for USB-A are from Pingwei and adopt DFN 3x3 package, 30V, 5.5mΩ. Finally, there is an eSoft MCU for the intelligent power distribution of each USB port. It integrates 6KB flash memory and 1KB SRAM memory, and the maximum frequency is 32MHz. Well, that's all components of this 6-port UGREEN desktop charger. Unlike the ordinary charger, you have to plug it into the wall outlet or power strip. This charger can be easily placed on your desktop and charge almost all your devices. The mass controller integrates independent PFC and LLC controller, and it also integrates 4 GaN chips from Innoscience used for LLC topology and PFC circuit. The higher integration makes it more compact. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!